everybody, this is Dan for Gamer D on Cars. Now, it's been a couple weeks since I filmed anything. I've been so busy with work and just doing stuff at home. It's starting to get nice outside, so I've been doing landscaping like crazy. But this is the first time I've got a chance to sort of poke around and just sort of look over this. This is a 2021 Land Rover Defender 110. Now, this is a car that's been legendary. It's been around forever, you know, since like the 60s and 70s, but they finally brought it back for 2020. It is a Defender 110, meaning it is the four-door. It's called the 90 is the two-door version, which I don't see one here at this dealer. By the way, I am at Land Rover Harrisburg. It's kind of funny it's called Land Rover Harrisburg, but it's technically in Carlisle. So I just want to go over, look at the different things about this Land Rover Defender. It's got a really cool, interesting color. There's lots of details that harken back to the original Defender. So let's take a look at the Defender 110. Now, I'm gonna use my little picture-in-picture app where you can see the car and you can also see me talking to the camera. So this is a Defender 110. I think they used to call it the 110 because the wheelbase was 110 inches and the 90 was 90-inch wheelbase. But this color, I think, looks really cool. And there's lots of details that, you know, this is an example of a car that they've modernized, but they kept some nice touches that the classic Defenders used to look like. Now, this P400 dynamic package has a couple little options here. This is like a sort of diamond plate look on the hood right there. And what I want to see what this color is called. It was something hard to pronounce. Gondwana Stone is what the color called. It looks like sort of like a pewterish tan. But this is a big car. Now, I hope when the Ford Bronco comes up, my Bronco, it is going to be about this size. But this car definitely has the off-road chops. You know, Land Rovers in general have been known to do off-road stuff. So just a couple details. This is the lights right here, and this harkens back to the original Defender lights. That this is the brake lights right there, then your reverse lights right there. But I'll flash a picture on the screen of a classic looking Defender. But this looks cool with like the black trim on the roof and then the trim on the side. Now this thing right here, this sort of floating Land Rover thing, I think on the inside there was some sort of storage. Now we can't get in the inside of this car because, you know, they're closed. There's an F-Type, by the way. But I think the proportions of this truck, this SUV, look really good. There's a little black trim on the bottom right there. Now this car has a 3-liter V6 engine, 395 horsepower, 406 foot-pounds of torque. It's an 8-speed automatic transmission, so this definitely has the power. I mean, these cars are not cheap. This car starts at $65,000, but this one is on sale for $73,000, which that is not cheap. I mean, I would totally consider this as a used car, you know, for someone like me that works on construction sites. But the Bronco, my Bronco is going to be about $45,000 and look amazing too, to have the styling like this car. But this car is $73,000. That is not cheap. But I mean, any product on this lot, you know, Evoques, F-Paces, Range Rovers, they are a lot of money. But the DRLs are right here. They just sort of have like a half eye shape right there. But I just love the vents and the little patterns and just sort of how that little fog light right there pops right in. Yeah, this is definitely an attractive looking SUV. Now, let's just try to peek on the inside just a little bit. Now, the inside sort of carries with the rugged theme. There's like the two dials right there and then the shifter. I'll go look on the other side, but it's got a classic looking layout. You can actually get it to where there's a third seat that pops down in the middle. I don't even know if you can see. But yeah, this car I think is really cool. There it says Motor Trend SUV of the Year for 2021. So you know that, you know, it's well respected by people in the car community. You got the fifth wheel on the back, which is kind of cool. I like the black finish of the wheels. But yeah, taking this thing off-road would be a blast. Now, let's see. Now, I plan to sort of take my Ford Bronco off-roading, but nothing too crazy. I'll just say soft-roading. But I think you can really go through some crazy stuff with this Defender here. So let's just see. I'm going to switch again. We're going to poke in to see if you can see the interior. Yeah, there's a stubby little shifter right there. Yeah, right there where my hand is. But yeah, this just sort of has simple utilitarian styling. There's like the little beads right there. But yeah, I think this Defender would be a really, really fun SUV. Let's say in 5 years, I bet you could get one of these for maybe 40 something thousand. And that would be a hell of an SUV. I mean, this is 400 horsepower, 400 foot-pounds of torque. I mean, that is some definite performance. Sure, it's a big, heavy SUV, but I think it looks great. So it's a Sunday here in April in Mechanicsburg in central Pennsylvania. I just wanted to go out. I always wanted to take a look at these up close. So this is the Land Rover Defender 2021. I think it looks amazing. I really like this color. I think this is a unique color that sort of goes along with the off-roading type and like safari type lifestyle that you would get with a car like this. So leave me a comment below. Let me know what you think of the Defender. Here, let's just get one little more close look right here. Hey, I'm down in the corner. Hi. So leave me a comment below. Let me know what you think about the Defender. I got a lot of cool car stuff coming up. I have two friends that have AMGs that they said I could drive. In a month or two, I'm going to get a chance to get my hands behind a C8 convertible. My friend just got one in Pittsburgh. But yeah, lots of cool stuff coming. I've been very busy at home and with work, so that's life. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram @GammyDonCars, and I will see you in the next one. See ya.